Hello everyone! Today we'll be looking at the Crucial P2 NVMe M.2 SSD, which is an entry-level NVMe SSD in Crucial's lineup. Specifically, we'll be unboxing and doing a quick benchmark test of the 500GB variant, which we have right here. Let's get started. Packaging-wise, nothing really fancy going on here, seeing as Crucial goes for its usual blue theme package, which is pretty much par for the course with Crucial's brand image. Moving on to the contents of the packaging. There's really not much here to write home about. We get a multi-language instruction leaflet. And the drive itself in a clamshell packaging. And here we have it, the P2 500GB in the flesh. Again, nothing too fancy going on here, no heat sinks or anything of that sort, seeing as this is a budget NVMe drive after all. Now, one thing to note about the P2 is that Crucial originally released the drive with TLC NAND flash memory back in 2020, but from 2021 onwards, they've since substituted TLC for the more inferior QLC NAND flash memory instead, which equates to a performance hit. Now, this whole NAND flash substitution debacle has been covered by media outlets such as Tom's Hardware and so on, so be sure to check out those articles to get some additional background on this drive. This particular model that I have here is of the QLC variant, owing to the fact that I could tell beneath the sticker that there are only two NAND flash chips, as opposed to the four chips for the original TLC variant. With that, let's get started with a quick benchmark to see how this drive performs. Here are the specs of the PC that I'll be using to do a test of this drive. I have the Crucial P2 installed on the second M.2 slot of my ASRock X570M Pro 4, and both M.2 slots on this board conform to the PCIe 4.0x4 standard. For the test-wise, I'll be using CrystalDiskMark 8.0.4 to benchmark this drive, and for the sake of comparison, I'll be comparing the P2 scores against my ADATA XPG SX8200 Pro 512GB, which was launched in 2019. And with that, let's get started with the benchmark. Unsurprisingly, the SX8200 Pro beats the P2 in almost every single test, bearing in mind that the SX8200 was positioned as a higher-end NVMe SSD back when it was released, and it would have been in a higher price bracket as well as compared to the Crucial P2. And with that, the Crucial P2 does what it's supposed to do, and that is to serve as an entry-level NVMe SSD, which would definitely boost the performance of users who are upgrading from, say, a traditional hard drive to run their operating system. As of March 2022, this drive is going for around $50 on platforms such as Amazon and Newegg, which pits it against competitor drives such as the WD Blue SN550. With that, thank you so much for watching, do like and subscribe if you've enjoyed this video, and I hope to catch you guys around the next time.